Hi guys, if you want to see how I made this small storage area behind me, or maybe like a mini closet when you're short on space, then keep watching. I'm gonna show you guys exactly how I did it, and I'm gonna leave prices and links down below.
You need to actually build a bookshelf. I'll have the link below and I'll have the price across the screen so y'all can see that. So this is the bookcase all built up. These shelves, there's three shelves that are removable, and there's one at the very bottom. So there's three removable shelves. This middle one is not removable, it's in place, it builds them two together. Once you've built that, I do recommend wiping it off because it's been there a while. So. Once you have the shelves in place where you want them, then next you're going to need tension rods. I have two tension rods because I'm going to put things on hangers in two separate places. My tension rods are white, as you can see here, and that's just because these are the solid fit my shelves. I'll show you guys exactly what I bought and everything.
If you want them to be more sturdy, but I don't, I like to move my things around, so that's why I'm not using it. It's a good thing. And if it's good, and put up under parts here, you know, weight. But since what I'm using doesn't really, or what I'm using it for doesn't really have a lot of weight, yet. Fine. After that, I'm going to use these baskets on the smaller shelf. So this one here. And I have three of those baskets, so we're going to put all three in. Now I have three smaller baskets. And then I have two huge baskets for underneath here. So you can make this another hanging shelf or anything, but I'm not doing that because I don't want to hang up clothes that won't be the right size at first, because that's what we can structure of it here with three baskets, three small baskets, two large baskets, and then two hanging shelves there. I do have a command hook over here on the side here, so I can hang something if I want to, which I will go ahead and hang something up. What I'm gonna hang up is this here. It's just a headband holder slash a hair bow holder. Hang it here. So there we are. Hair bows a little bit. Okay. So now that we have that, if you guys are interested in one of those, it's like that purple one here. They are on my Etsy shop, so if you want to purchase them, I'll leave that link below as well so you guys can see that. And now we're gonna start putting everything else on so y'all can see it come together, okay? So this is just the blanket that I made, also on my Etsy shop. So, yeah. I'm just gonna sit this right here because I don't have a lot of bottoms in newborn size, so we're gonna sit that there. And then for the bottoms, I put them all on hangers. They have not been washed yet, as it's not time for me to wash them yet, so yeah. Okay.
So at the very bottom on the left side are clothes that are 0 to 3 months. And then on the right side, those are clothes that are bigger than 3 months. So that's why they're over there. And then lastly, this is just her car seat cover that I made her. So I'm just going to fold that up here really quickly. And then we're going to put this at the very top. Show you guys my detail. So that's how it looks. The car seat cover that I made is also on my Etsy, so you can check that out too. Link below. So this is how it looks for my DIY storage. These are just some receiving blankets, some passies, and a pair of stockings, and then this is where her socks will go. I am going to take the passies out of here since she'll be using them. It's only two, but I'm going to take them out of here, and then this will change into where her hats go. So her hats are going to go here, and then all her sock items are going to go here. So I should move this home so this way I can cut off. So yeah, that's how it will go. And yeah. If you have any questions for me, just leave them down below in the comments. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel so you can see all of my future content. Leave any comments below, and I'll see you guys next time.